Hello everyone, this is Cheshta and I would be discussing this daily MCQs of May 20, 2018. As Anuj is unwell, so for the time being I would be discussing these daily MCQs which are important for the examinations like RBI Phase 1, SBI, IBPS, SSC 2018. Let's start with the first question. The question asks, BrahMos Aerospace was formed as a joint venture between which of the following countries? The correct answer is India and Russia. So the two organizations, which is DRDO, the Defense Research and Development Organization of India, and the joint stock company NPO, Mashinostroya of Russia, have come up to form this BrahMos Aerospace joint venture. Also, BrahMos supersonic cruise missile is the world's fastest supersonic cruise missile. The word BrahMos has been formed from the two rivers, BrahMos, which is Brahmbra, which is taken from the Brahmaputra river of India, and the Mos, which is taken from the Moskva river of Russia. Currently, there are three missile testing centers in India, or the rocket launch sites in India. The first one is situated in Kerala, which is the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, which is located in Thimbu, Thiruvananthapuram. Another one, which is Satish Dhawan Space Center, is located in Andhra Pradesh, in Sriharikota. And the last one is located in Odisha. The name is Abdul Kalam Island, which is located in Odisha, Chandipur. This BrahMos supersonic cruise missile was recently test fired from the Chandipur. So the Odisha coast, it is the Chandipur location. Let's move on to the next question. What is the GDP growth rate ICRA expects for India in the fourth quarter of the fiscal 2017-18? The correct answer for this question is 7.4%. Recently, ICRA projected the growth rate for the quarter third, which is 7.2%. Now it has been increased to 7.4% for the quarter fourth of the fiscal year 2018. What is ICRA? ICRA is the credit rating agency of India. ICRA is the Credit Rating Agency of India, which stands for Investment Information and Credit Rating Agency of India Limited. What is a credit rating agency? A credit rating agency is an independent company which actually evaluates the financial conditions of issuers. The issuers which issue debt issuers, the financial conditions of the debt issuers is evaluated, then they are assigned the ratings. These ratings actually tell about the ability of the issuer to make the debt payment. Currently, there are only four credit rating agencies in India, which are, the first one is CRISIL, which is Credit Rating Info Services of India Limited. Another one is ICRA, which is again the Investment Information and Credit Rating Agency of India. The third one is CARE, which stands for Credit and Research Limited. And the last one is DCR India, which is the Dubb Phelps Credit Rating India Private Limited. Another question. Which of the following is the second wealthiest country as per the AFR Asia Bank Global Wealth Migration Review? The correct answer for this question is China. US has topped the list with $62,584 billion wealth. The second one is China, which has $24,803 billion wealth. The third one is the Japan. India stands at the sixth position with 8230 of wealth. So India is the sixth wealthiest country in the world. The list is topped by the US. Next question. Which of the following states has launched the Krishi Mahabhyan Kam Bij Vikas Vahan Rath? This Krishi Mahabhyan Bij Vikas Vahan Rath actually subsumes the two schemes under it. The first one is the Kharif Mahabhyan Kam Mahotsav Rath. Another one is the Bij Vahan Vikas Rath. The answer for this question is actually Bihar. Bihar has launched this scheme. The Kharif Mahabhyan Kam Mahotsav Rath is actually the rath which would travel to the blocks and gram panchayats and villages to tell the farmers about the schemes. So this would tell about the schemes which are actually run by the government during the Kharif seasons. And this Bij Vahan Vikas Rath would distribute the Kharif seeds and the pesticides for the treatment of the Kharif crop. So Bihar has launched this Krishi Mahabhyan Kam Bij Vikas Vahan Rath. Next question, which is, recently which state has announced that 10% of all police force will be reserved for women? The answer for this question is Tripura. Tripura has come up with this reservation thing that 10% of all the police force would be reserved for the women. As there is very less amount of women participating in the police force, therefore this has been implemented by the Tripura government so that they could encourage women to participate more efficiently. As per this graph, Chandigarh has topped the list with 14.616% participation in the police force, and among the top 10, Manipur is the least one, which has the 8.22% participation. When we look at this percentage of women police, the bottom 10 states, Madhya Pradesh has the 4.82% participation, West Bengal has 4.77% participation, and we could see that Assam is at the lowest position with 0.93% participation, which is actually less than 1%. So, just to encourage women to fight against the crimes, Tripura has reserved 10% of the police force for the women. Another thing, a Prayas committee, it's a state level committee which has been formed to deal with the issues related to the women, and this committee has been formed in each police station. So Tripura has recently launched that 10% of the police force will be reserved for the women along with this Prayas committee, which is formed to encourage women to come up to them to discuss their issues. Next question. Who among the following is the first female turbaned Sikh who has been inducted as auxiliary police officer in the New York Police Department? So for the first time, the New York Police Department has actually appointed Guru Suvach Kaur as the first female turbaned Sikh in the police department as an auxiliary police officer. Before this, no other female turbaned Sikh was actually appointed as a police officer in the New York Police Department. The next question is, when is the Anti-Terrorism Day observed in India? The correct answer for this question is May 21st. May 21st is celebrated all over India as Anti-Terrorism Day. This day is actually observed to make people aware of the danger of terrorism and how this terrorism is impacting the human sufferings and the lives of the people. This day was observed first time in the year 1991 when our former Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated. It was occurred as a result of the suicide bombing. This was the first time a human bomb was used for the assassination. It was the first time suicide bombing was done. It was done by the Dhanu member, Dhanu. He was the member of the Litte community, which is the Liberation Tigers of Tamil Elam. It is a military organization in the Sri Lanka. So from 1990, so since 1991, this day, Anti-Terrorism Day, is observed in India each year on May 21st. The last question is, who won the Palme d'Or award at Cannes Film Festival 2018? The answer for this question is Hirokazu Koreeda. Hirokazu Koreeda is a Japanese director who has won this award for the movie Shoplifters. This Palme d'Or award is the top prize given at the Cannes Film Festival. Also, this Palme d'Or award is also known as Golden Palm Award. Along with this award, the Best Actress award was given to the Samuel Yeselimova, and the Best Actor award was given to Marcelo Fonte. So the Palme d'Or award or the Golden Palm Award for 2018 was given to Hirokazu Koreeda, who is a Japanese director. If you like the video, you can subscribe to the channel Anuj Jindal. Also, you can join the YouTube community where the daily quizzes and the MCQs are provided. You can connect us through Facebook, Telegram, WhatsApp or Twitter. The link for the same are already mentioned in the description. You can also download the Google Play app, which is Infinity app, which is actually the depository of our quiz and the current affairs. Thank you.